Many 49ers fans, including myself, have been wondering what the 49ers are going to do at the right tackle position. And while they signed Colton McKivitz, to many, this seemed like not enough. But what if I told you they may have just stolen their starting right tackle in Joey Fisher? Initially, when the 49ers signed Fisher, I was stoked and saw him as a year two guy. But recently, the more and more I watch his film and compare him to Colton McKivitz, I think he can make a push to start this year. So I think it'd be interesting to look deeper into Joey Fisher and how he compares with Colton McKivitz. First, let's compare their sizes. Colton McKivitz is 6'6", 301, and he has longer arms, while Joey Fisher is 6'4", and 296 pounds. Colton McKivitz is also much slower than Joey Fisher, running his 40-yard dash in 5.35 seconds, while Joey Fisher ran his in 4.97 seconds, which was one of the fastest times in this year's draft class. Colton McKivitz coming out put up the bench press 20 times. Joey Fisher laughs at that and puts up the bench press twice as many times with 40 reps, absurdly strong. Athletically, it appears that Joey Fisher is more athletic and stronger than Colton McKivitz. While McKivitz has length in his arms and height, he also has a bit more weight. So now that we understand the comparison between McKivitz and Fisher a little bit more, let's dive into Fisher and the type of player he is and what impact he can make on the 49ers team. Joey Fisher was a 3-year starter and captain at Shepherd, where he played his college football. That's Division II school. And when he was playing out on the field, he made each and every player that he played against look like a Division II athlete because he routinely threw these guys around. He's a broad frame guy with NFL thickness in his upper and lower body. His strength also goes along with that. He fits into blocks with forceful double underhooks. He's the power to torque opponents off balance. You'll see this often. He'll just kind of throw a guy off balance just because he has that torque ability. And one of the biggest knocks on Fisher, and probably why he wasn't drafted, is he went to a Division II school. So he played against a lower level of competition, and he must prove he can handle NFL size and strength. And while he sometimes grabs people outside the pads, which may lead to holding penalties in the NFL, I think the offensive lineman coach for the 49ers and Chris Forrester will be able to clean some of those things up. But if he's able to take those steps necessary, he looks like a starter opposite of Trent Williams. He's aggressive and mean, exactly what the 49ers are looking for on their offense. One of the crazy things about this whole situation is that the 49ers didn't even have to use a draft pick on Joey Fisher. Many analysts actually had 49ers selecting Fisher with pick number 99. Luckily, they didn't have to do that and picked him up as an undrafted free agent, which makes Joey Fisher an absolute steal. I don't know what other lineman you can get that is one of the fastest linemen and strongest as an undrafted free agent. The 49ers made the perfect move here. But that's just how much I like Joey Fisher. I think he's the perfect tackle for the 49ers, and while his arms aren't necessarily the longest, I think he's proven that he has the strength and athletic ability to succeed in the NFL. But Fisher must refine his technique, which lies in the offensive line coach Chris Forster's hands. What do you think about this Joey Fisher signing? Do you like it? Do you think that he could be the starting right tackle? Or is it going to be Colton McKivitz?